equal signs here. All right. Everybody ready to go?
Nope, not yet.
All right. 1-3. Writing expressions. Okay. So, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be kind of translating. We're going to be translating words into mathematical phrases, mathematical sentences. So we're going to start with these. These are our basic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And you can see in each of the boxes here, I have one word that is a way to describe that operation. So one way I can say addition is with the word sum. One way I can say subtraction is decreased by. Multiplication, we sometimes say times. And division is quotient. What else can we add to this list? What's another way to say addition? Additionally. What else?
Plus.
Anything else? What about more? More than?
Increase.
Oh, I like that one. More than. Is that good? Okay. What about subtraction?
Other way.
Minus. Okay, just yell them out. What else? Minus. Subtract. Keep going. Less. I heard. So I'm going to start with an S over here. Sum is addition. Get that one ready. But there's a word that starts with a D that's like some. You know what it is?
Difference.
That's what we're looking for here. We already got minus. Anything else you want to add to that list?
Subtraction.
Okay. Multiplication. So obviously we could say multiply. Or multiplication. Add that to that. What else?
Product
is the fancy math term. What else? We've got a lot of symbols. So you've got a dot. What else could represent multiplication? The little star, if somebody's typing it. Parentheses. And then yes, an X, but do we want to use that in algebra? Because maybe something good to talk about, right? Because if we put an X there, it looks like a variable. So we want to try to avoid those. Also, I would add to this list the word of. If you see the word of, that's going to be a multiplication in the problem. Okay? What about division?
Division.
Division.
Divide
or division. Okay, what else? Fraction or
dividend.
Dividend is part of a division problem, but it's not the dividing itself. So, but I like where you're going with that.
What did you say again? I wasn't sure.
Fraction. I'm not gonna say decimal. Fraction is division, though. We'll keep that. Yes.
Split.
So if you split among a certain amount of people, you're dividing. Okay, so what we just created here is just a list of keywords, right? We're trying to translate words, English, into math. So what you're going to be looking for are these keywords. If you're not sure if you should use addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division, you find these keywords, and hopefully that tells you which operation you want to include. Now, one thing we want to be careful of, subtraction and division. We know order matters, right? We talked about that in warm-up. We can't just switch the order whenever we feel like it. So when you have a problem that involves subtraction and division, do not change the order. If the X comes first in the sentence, keep the X first in the subtraction. Same thing with the division. Does that make sense? Order matters for those. Addition and multiplication, it won't matter. All right. So this is just the same thing we talked about together. Let's do these together now. We are going to translate English to math. Write an expression. Number one. 7 more than a number B.
7 more than a number b.
What equals 7?
Good. Is there any other way I could write it?
7 plus b
would also be acceptable because addition is commutative.
You already get the same answer.
The product of 11 and a number x.
Product of 11 and a number x.
11 times x. And a few different ways you could write it. If it's me, I'm just going to write 11x. You can also write 11 with the dot, 11 with the parentheses, any of those would be fine. Okay? The difference of 18 and a number c.
Go ahead. 18
minus c. Good. Could I write c minus 18?
No.
No. Subtraction order is going to matter, so if 18 comes first in our sentence, we're going to keep it on the left side. Okay. The quotient of a number n and 15. N divided by 15. A few different ways you can write it. If it's me, I'm just making a fraction. Easiest way to do it. You could also do something like this with a slash. You could use the actual division symbol, which really in algebra you're not going to see that a ton. Again, this is one where you do not want to switch the order of those. We don't want to put the 15 first. Last one, the sum of 2 and a number x. We already did a sum one, so actually let's just skip that one. Okay. Questions on those? You get the idea of what we're doing here?
Uh-huh.
With me? Any questions? No? Okay. All right, more challenging ones. I've got 3 problems on here. I want you guys to try these with a partner or somebody you're sitting here to if you don't have your partner with you today. See if you can translate these from English to math. I'll give you a couple minutes. Let's talk about them. I'm going to start with what I think is the easiest one up here, and that's the actual one at the bottom. The difference between 15 and the square of a number m. Difference means subtraction. 15 comes first, so it should be 15 minus. When we see square of, what are we doing?
M with a little 2 next to it.
M with a little 2 next to it. You're squaring it. What if I want to take something to the third power? What would it say?
M with a little 3 next to it.
Well, we wouldn't say that in the sentence, right? M cubed. You might see something like that show up. That means take it to the third power. All right, number 2. 6 times. Okay, well, hopefully that's pretty obvious, right? The sum of 4 and a number y. So what do we have to do with 4 and y?
Put in parentheses.
Okay. And do what with them?
Add
them. Does everybody agree that 6 is being multiplied by both 4 and y? That's what the parentheses tell us, okay? If you see the word quantity show up, that means you're probably using a parenthesis. That may show up in some of the homework problems, okay? If it says 6 times the quantity of 4 and y or something like that, you want to put a parenthesis in your problem. Also, you could have y plus 4. If you switch that order, that would be okay. The one at the top, 5 less than the quantity 7 times a number. Now, it doesn't say what the number is, so you guys can use any variable you want. So let's say I use an x. There should be a 7x somewhere in your problem. Yes? Now, if you made a mistake, I'm a mind reader. I can tell what you did. Your 5's on the wrong side. When something is less than, don't we take it away, right? If I have 8 M&Ms and I have 5 less than that, I do 8 minus 5. Yes? Okay. So whenever you see less than, make sure you put it at the end of the sentence.
Okay? That was right.
Be very careful with less than. It's a super tricky one. Am I a mind reader? Did you make that mistake?
No, I'm surprising. I thought I did it.
I didn't trick you? Okay. Questions? Okay. These are the only word problems we're going to be doing today, and I wouldn't even call them word problems. We've just got phrases really written here. Again, if you're taking notes, you are not writing this down for word, just the important information. We again are trying to write an expression here. The height of a wall that is B bricks tall if each brick is 3 inches tall. Okay, we want to write an expression to try to figure that out. Now, it's kind of boggling when you have a variable there. We don't know B, how many bricks there are. So if you're not sure what expression to write, the great thing about a variable is it varies. You can put in whatever you want. So if I told you, for example, there were 5 bricks, how would you figure out how tall the wall was? You would multiply. That's your answer. If you're not sure what operation to use, put a number in there and decide, how would I do that calculation? We need to multiply 3 times however many bricks there are. Does that make sense? It's a lot easier when I put a number in there, huh? Okay. The number of miles in a 4-mile walk that are left if you've already walked M miles. Give me a number for M.
3.
Sure. If I've already walked 3 miles in a 4-mile walk, how many miles are left? 1. And how do you get that 1? Subtract 4 minus however many miles you've already walked. Whatever's left. That's not too bad, right? Don't make the variables intimidating. Each person share if P people share 3 gallons of water. Okay, so how many people? Give me a number. 4 people are sharing 3 gallons of water. What would you do? Would you do 3 divided by 4 or 4 divided by 3? What do you think? Definitely division. You would do 3 divided by 4. You would take how much you have and divide it by how many people are sharing it. You could take fraction, or you could use the division symbol if you want there. Questions? Okay. The last little thing that is in this lesson has to do with rates and unit rates. Again, you do not have to write this down word for word, whatever you feel like is important from this. A rate, important, is a fraction that compares two quantities. An example of a rate is miles per hour. And I just did division, but I said what word?
Per.
If you see per, more than likely that's division, right? That's an example of a rate. It tells us our speed when we're driving down the road. A unit rate is a rate where the denominator is 1. Fraction that compares two quantities that are different units is a rate. So an example is miles per hour. And when the denominator is 1, we have a special name. It is a unit rate. All right, last couple examples. Find the unit rate for the following examples, and we're going to make sure we label them. Okay? I have $120 spent on 10 admission tickets. All you have to do to find a unit rate is divide them.
That's $12 per ticket.
Right, and you've labeled it correctly. What this is calculating, if we look at the units, is dollars and tickets. So if you do the division, you end up with 12, or you could write 12 over 1 if you want. That's where you can see that denominator of 1. Dollars per ticket. Again, that word per is coming from the fact that we are dividing. $120 to split over 10 admission tickets. My unit rate calculates how much is each ticket. Okay, I have 6 cups for 3 servings. 6 cups for 3 servings. What's the unit rate? Perfect. 2 cups per serving. Does that make sense? Yeah? Okay. 40 flowers for 5 vases.
8 flowers per vase.
Beautiful. 8 flowers. And sometimes we don't even write the word per, we just do this. Per vase. My unit rate. That's it. 1.3. Done.
Yeah, fine.
Any questions?
Here we go.
No.
No, that's not.
All right. So, a couple things. Number one, there are 2 worksheets you will see in your packet over 1.3. The first one is like a magician something little picture on it. That is bonus. You do not have to do it if you don't want to. If you would like a few bonus points, if you're going to do it for tickets, remember the tickets are worth product bonus points, you can try that for Monday. Otherwise, your homework this weekend is the next riddle worksheet that you see in the packet, which is the Firefly Riddle Worksheet. On Monday, we are going to be reviewing together for your very first quiz Monday night. You're going to have a review in Polaris for that quiz, and on Tuesday it is your quiz. Now, quick question. If you are absent on Monday and come back on Tuesday, what will I make you do on Tuesday?
Take
a quiz. So if you are absent on Monday, you better make sure before you return to school, you have watched the YouTube video and or got the notes offline from the study guide. And if you still have questions, pop in my room in the morning before school starts to get those answers.
Wait, our YouTube videos don't really want to be close. I'm going to be a serious one for the best for all of you.
No, it's... All right, winner today is 8.
I just flicked him. I said,
"Hey." All right.
Nice job, Miss. You got lucky.
We're past.